under the limitation clause. The right, stroke freedom to vote, and the right, stroke freedom to stand for office are conceptually inseparable, as they form equally integral parts of the democratic state. The core issue for determination now is whether the petition discloses a case to demonstrate that the decision to complain of and all the reasons offered for excluding the petitioner from the presidential contest amount to discrimination within the meaning of Article 27 of the Constitution. To me, the guiding principles in a case of this nature are clear. The first step is to establish whether the Gazette notice complained of differentiates between different presidential candidates. The second step entails establishing whether that differentiation amounts to discrimination. The third step involves determining whether the discrimination is unfair. This is where the answer lies, period. I must add that if the discrimination on any of the listed grounds in Article 27.4 of the Constitution is presumed to be unfair. It must be noted, however, that once an allegation of unfair discrimination based on any of the listed grounds in Article 27.4 of the Constitution is made and established, the burden lies on the respondent to prove that such discrimination did not take place or that it is justified. The judiciary is an essential component of our constitutional democracy, and judicial authority is vested in the courts by the Constitution. Allegations of actual bias or reasonable apprehension of bias or discrimination certainly raise a constitutional issue. The Constitution forbids unfair discrimination, regardless of the context in which it occurs, and irrespective of whether the perpetrator is the state or a private person. Article 27 provides that a person shall not discriminate directly or indirectly against another person on any ground, including ground specified or contemplated in clause 4. The right to equality and freedom from discrimination is protected by international and legal frameworks that Kenya is a signatory to. The Constitution provides that general rules of international law, treaties, and conventions ratified by Kenya shall form part of law of Kenya. Article 2 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights provides, quote, every person is entitled to all rights and freedoms set forth in this declaration without distinction of any kind, such as race, color, sex, language, religion, political or other opinion, national or social, original property, birth or other status. Furthermore, no distinction shall be made on the basis of the political, jurisdictional or international status of the country or territory to which a person belongs, whether it be independent, trust, non-self-governing, or under any other limitation of sovereignty, end of quote. This is echoed in Article 2 of the African Charter of Human and People's Rights, which states, every individual shall be entitled to the enjoyment of the rights and freedoms recognized and guaranteed in the present charter without distinction of any kind, such as race, ethnic group, color, sex, language, religion, political or other opinion, national and social origin, fortune, birth, or other status, end of quote. Equality is one of the philosophical foundations of human rights, and it is intimately connected to the concept of justice. The concept is expansive, but at its core, it speaks the language of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights of 1948, which stipulates that, quote, all are equal before the law and are entitled without any discrimination to equal protection of the law, end of quote. Equality at its core communicates the idea that people who are similarly situated in relevant ways should be treated similarly. The European Convention of Human Rights defined discrimination as treating differently without an objective and reasonable justification persons in similar situation. At the heart of the prohibition of unfair discrimination lies the recognition that the purpose of a constitutional and democratic order is the establishment of a society in which all human beings will be accorded equal dignity and respect regardless of their membership or particular groups or status. To this extent, the goal of the Constitution should not be forgotten or overlooked. The Canadian Supreme Court, analyzing the subject of discrimination, had the following to say, quote, this court has recognized that inherent human dignity is at the heart of individual rights in a free and democratic society. More than any other right in the Charter, equality is that concept is enshrined as a fundamental human right means nothing if it does not represent a commitment to recognizing each person's equal worth as a human being, regardless of individual differences. Equality means that our society cannot tolerate distinctions that treat certain people as second-class citizens, that demean them, that treat them as less capable for no good reason, or that otherwise offend fundamental human dignity, end of quote. The Constitution is the supreme law of the Republic and binds all persons. The Constitution enjoins the court to interpret the Constitution in a manner that promotes its purposes, values and principles, and advances the rule of law, human rights and fundamental freedoms in the Bill of Rights, and in a manner that contributes to good governance. This court is obliged to protect and promote the purposes and principles of the Constitution. The Constitution should be given a purposive liberal interpretation. This court is bound to adopt the interpretation that most favors the enforcement of the petitioner's right to equality and non-discrimination. Such an interpretation inevitably leads me to the irresistible conclusion that the exclusion of the petitioner from the ballot in the elections scheduled for 26 October 2016 is a violation of his rights to political participation and is also unfair, hence discriminatory. The next question is whether the petitioner considered defeat. The Supreme Court stated, if the petitioner was only one of the candidates and who had taken the second position in vote tallying to the president-elect, then the fresh election will in law be confined to the petitioner and the president-elect. And all the remaining candidates, underlining now, who did not contest the election of the president-elect would be assumed to have either considered defeat or acquiesced in the results as declared by IEBC, and such candidates may not participate in the fresh election, end of quote. The petitioner has stated earlier participated in the petition number 1 of 2017 as an interested party and supported the petition which led to the nullification of the results. Can he be assumed as having considered defeat? I do not think so. Having contested the election in that he participated in the petition as an interested party and supported the petition, he cannot be deemed to have considered defeat. His father affidavit, which has not been challenged or rebutted, explains the circumstances under which he issued a statement conceding defeat and the reason why he retracted the statement. On the whole, I find no legal basis to justify the first and second respondents' decision to exclude the petitioner from contesting in the fresh elections. In view of my conclusions and above, I find that this petition has merits. Consequently, I find that the petitioner is entitled to the relief sought. Accordingly, I make the following orders stroke declarations. 1. A declaration B and C hereby issued that the petitioner's rights under Articles 38, 27, and 140, sub Article 3 of the Constitution have been and continue to be infringed, violated, and or denied by the first and second respondents' failure to include him as a presidential candidate in the fresh election slated for 26 September 2017. B, an order B and C hereby issued compelling the first and second respondents to immediately issue a fresh Gazette notice and or amend the Gazette notice dated 5th September 2016 by way of a corrigendum to include the petitioner herein as a presidential candidate for the Third Way Alliance Party in the fresh elections scheduled for 26 September 2017. No orders as to costs. Sorry and thanks for your patience. It was fairly long, but we had to go through it. It was ready by Friday, by the way. I said that, only that I couldn't get you. A day before after we had it.
Right, live pictures from Milimani, the High Court, where Justice John Motivo has just handed down a landmark ruling.